Hello again, and welcome to our Lenten devotionals for the year 2022. This devotional is for April 6th. And again, it is a familiar psalm. I think for some people, it's their favorite psalm. Again, it's a psalm that has been set to music in many different ways and many different times. It's Psalm 121. So we have skipped a few as we have come through our Lenten devotional time. Psalm 121, I think probably some of you could probably quote it with me, at least the first part. And we're going to read the whole psalm. It is fairly short. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where will my help come? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. He who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in from this time on and forevermore. A beautiful psalm. It is listed among the Psalms of Ascent, that is those who are going up, usually perhaps going up to the temple, making some kind of pilgrimage. We've had a couple of those Psalms already. And it is sometimes called a Psalm of a sojourner, somebody who is going on a journey. And indeed, there are those folks who recite this Psalm whenever they are going to go on a journey, that God will keep them. And it's not unusual for Jewish families to have this psalm posted in the delivery room or in a baby stroller or in the child's room, that the Lord will be the keeper of the goings out and comings in. And it's really a psalm of everyday blessings. It has two different parts, and you'll notice that the words change from part to part. So verses 1 and 2 ask the question. Now, we might not have heard it as a question. We might have heard it. We might have learned it. I lift up my eyes to the hills from whence my help comes, which is another way to translate it. But there is this sense of, if you're going on a journey, you want to know where your help is going to come from. In modern times, I've talked about getting an electric car, but for me, only one person, and I take long trips, I want to be able, there's going to be a place to recharge a car. And so I'm still sort of wedded to a place where I can know that I could put gas in the car and keep going. Where are the helps along the way? And these two verses are what they call in Hebrew poetry, a chiasm, which it means they cross one another. So we have, I will lift up my eyes to the hills, from whence comes my help. And then down here, my help comes from the Lord who created the hills. So we have this sense, and this happens a lot in Hebrew poetry, a chiasm. And you look to the hills, but we're not going to trust the hills themselves to protect us. As a matter of fact, the hills might be hiding some hidden danger. We look to the hills, where is our help coming from? And then we remember that our help comes from the Lord, the one who made the hills. And so that is our ultimate help. And so we have the questioner of the traveler, from where will my help come? My help comes from the Lord. And then we have a blessing. And you notice it's the pronouns are not my and I anymore. Now that the Lord will keep you, he will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. The Lord will neither slumber nor sleep. And we have here, most importantly, most crucially, an image of God as the keeper, God who will keep us as we go about our daily lives. I've always loved this psalm. And this translation says you're going out and you're coming in. And I think I learned it as your goings out and your comings in, which to me has more of a sense of every time we go out, every time we come back in, the Lord is keeping us. Every day. And it reminds us every day to say a blessing, to remember a blessing, to remember the Lord's blessing. And there are those who will who will say a blessing every night when you go to bed, or say a blessing in the morning when you get up, to remind us that it is the Lord who is our keeper, the Lord who will watch over our goings out and our comings in. We have so many of them, don't we? All of our lives, going out and coming in. And each one of those, each one of those trips to the grocery store, each one of those trips farther away to visit somebody, each meeting that we go to, our goings out and our comings in, all are under the watchful care of the Lord who keeps us. Let's pray together. Lord, we thank you that you don't slumber or sleep even while we slumber and sleep, that you are always ready to keep us, to protect us, to make our journeys possible. We pray that we may remember that in this Lenten journey, and indeed in the journey of our lives, that we may know that you keep us in all of our ways. We thank you for that, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you again for being with me on this Lenten devotional journey.